Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan lana naqalu al-Qur'ana 'azban wa salsala faminhum budurun sab'atun qad tawasatat sama' al-'ula wal 'adl zuhran wa kummala.
Brothers and sisters, in this episode, inshallah ta'ala, it's going to be the third response to the first shubha that was brought, which is that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. In this episode, I want to speak about the mutaakhirina min al-ulama'i, the scholars who came after, who distinguished between the Qur'an being mutawatir, but not necessarily the qira'at. There are great scholars who have said that the Qur'an is mutawatir, but they said not necessarily the qira'at. So they distinguish between those two. These great scholars, as a side note, they opposed the ijma' that we mentioned previously. We transmitted ijma' from great scholars. They've gone against that. That's something for every student to know. Another thing that I want to say is that from the characteristics of a solid student of knowledge and a person of knowledge is that you study what is for you as much as you study what is against you. First of all, you ground yourself without a doubt what is for you, and then you go out and you study what is against you. ولذلك وكيع بن جراح الرؤاسي, the teacher of Imam al-Shafi'i, he رحمه الله, he said, أهل العلم, the people of knowledge, يكتبون ما لهم وما عليهم وأهل الأهواء لا يكتبون إلا ما لهم. الإمام الدارقطني narrated this in his Sunan. Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ansari, Shaykh al-Islam Abu Ismail al-Harawi, he narrated in his kitab Dhammul Kalami wa Ahli. Al-Imam ibn al-Jawzi narrated in his kitab At-Tahqiqu fi Masail al-Khilaf. And also Ibn Tahir al-Qaysarani al-Maqdisi narrated in his kitab As-Sama' that Waqi' ibn Jarrah said, Ahlul Ilmi, the people of knowledge, they write what is for them and they write what is against them. As for the people of desires, they only write what is for them. They don't care what is against them. So it's necessary to know what is for you and what is against you, so your proof can become stronger, your arguments are very solid. And that is why I'm going to always mention what other people have said, even if we don't agree with them, because we have to have answers for their statements and what they've said. So without a shadow of a doubt, there are great scholars who have said that the Qur'an is mutawatir, not necessarily the qira'at. They've gone against the ijma', and that itself is enough to say that what they are saying is wrong. But again, inshallah ta'ala, I'm still going to go into detailed response regarding them, inshallah ta'ala. Before I go in, there are 2 points I want to bring to your attention, my beloved brothers and sisters. Number one, those great scholars who have said that the Qur'an is mutawatir, but not necessarily the qira'at, they are not saying in any way, shape or form that all that is enough regarding the Qur'an is that there is a sahih sanad from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that it has to be in line with the rasm of the masahif of Uthman, and it has to also be in line in the Arabic language. They are not saying that. With the chain being authentic, they are also saying that it has to be the recitation which is famous, it is prevalent, and the Ummah have unanimously agreed upon it. So what we say is that أَنَا عَدَمُ اشْتِرَاطِ هَؤُلَاءِ الْمُتَأَخِرِينَ لِلتَّوَاتُرِ لا يعني أنهم يكتفون في قبول القراءة بمجرد مجيئها بإسناد صحيح. They're not saying that. What they are saying is that it has to be القراءة مشهورة. The قراءة must be famous. It has to have spread. Second thing they're adding onto there is وَتَلَقَّتْهَا الْأُمَّةِ بِالْقَبُولِ, and that the Ummah have all agreed upon it. So they're saying it has to be authentic. That's one. The chain of it has to be authentic. Number two, they are saying it has to be famous and prevalent, and it has to be commonly known by everybody. That's two. Number three, وَتَلَقَّتْهُ الْأُمَّةُ بِالْقَبُولِ, and that the ummah have all accepted it. Ijma'. They're conditioning those three. Sihatu sanad, shuhra, wastifada. And the third thing that they're conditioning is تَلَقَّتْهُ الْأُمَّةُ بِالْقَبُولِ. تَلَقَّتْهُ الْأُمَّةُ بِالْقَبُولِ, that the ummah have agreed upon it. Let me give you their statements themselves. One of the great scholars who've actually held the opinion that the tawatur is not a condition for the qira'at is none other than the imam of this field of Qur'an, Shamsuddin ibn al-Jazari, who died in 833 Hijriah. He mentions in his kitab, An-Nashr fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr, he says, when he was explaining the part, وَصَحَ سَنَدُهَا, when he was explaining that line of his. We know that Al-Imam Al-Jazari rahimahullah, he mentions in his Tayyibatul Nashr, which is the poetry of the Nashr, في القراءات العشر, he said, فَكُلُّ مَا وَافَقَ وَجْهَ النَّحْوِ وَكَانَ لِلْرَسْمِ احْتِمَالًا يَحْوِي وَصَحَ إِسْنَادًا هُوَ الْقُرْآنُ فَهَذِهِ ثَلَاثَةُ الْأَرْكَانُ وَحِيثُمَا يَخْتَلُّ الرُّكْنُ الْأَثْبِتِ شُذُوذَهُ لَوْ أَنَّهُ فِي سَبْعَةِ, right? So in that line of poetry, what did he say? وَصَحَ إِسْنَادًا. So he's explaining that. What does it mean, وَصَحَ إِسْنَادُهَا? He said, what do I mean by that? He's explaining his own statement. He said, فَإِنَّا نَعْنِي بِهِ, what we mean by this is, أَنْ يَرْوِيَ تِلْكَ الْقِرَاءَةِ الْعَدْلُ الضَّابِطُ عَنْ مِثْلِهِ كَذَا حَتَّى تَنْتَهِيَ وَتَكُونَ مَعَ ذَلِكَ مَشْهُورَةً عِنْدَ أَئِمَّةِ هَذَا الشَّأْنِ الضَّابِطِينَ لَهُ وَغَيْرَ مَعْدُودَةٍ عِنْدَهُمُ مِنَ الْغَلَطِ أَوْ مِمَّا شَدَّ بِهَا بَعْضُهُمْ. He said, what we mean by وَصَحَّ سَنَدُهَا is فَإِنَّا نَعْنِي بِأَنْ يَرْوِي تِلْكَ الْقِرَاءَةِ, that this qira'ah is narrated, transmitted by who? Al-adlu, a just individual. Al-dabit, a person who is precise in his memory. An-mithlihi, from someone like him. Hatta tantayya, until it finishes at the ending of the chain. يعني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَتَكُونُ مَعَ ذَلِكَ مَشْهُورَةً, and that it becomes famous and prevalent and it spreads. عند أئمة هذا الشأن, to who لكن, to every عمر بكر زيد, لا, to the scholars of this field, they consider this قراءة to be مشهور, famous. الضابطين له, those scholars are precise who are great, they consider this قراءة to be مشهور. غير معدودة عندهم من الغلط, and they do not consider this قراءة to be a mistake. أو مما شد بها بعضهم, or they do not consider it a recitation that some people have become alone in. So Ibn al-Jazari is conditioning with sihatu sanad, he's conditioning shuhra wal istifada. Shuhra wal istifada, that is famous and is prevalent and is spread. He also said in his kitab Munjid al-Muqri'ina an al-qira'at al-ashr, when he was talking about it, the qira'at al-ashr, he said about it, wa amma al-ashr fa ajma'a an-nas, the people have all agreed ala talaqqiha bil qabuli, they've all agreed to accept it. La yunazi'u fi dhalika illa jahilun, and no one argues in that except an ignorant person. So if we begin statement in Munjid al-Muqri'in, when he was talking about the qira'at al-ashr, and his statement in an-nashr fi al-qira'at al-ashr, two things come together, which is what? That he conditions Ibn al-Jazari أن تكون هذه القراءة مشهورة وتلقتها الأمة بالقبول, and that the ummah have all unanimously agreed upon it. That's point number one that I want to bring your attention. Because some brothers and some sisters whose knowledge and understanding of the great scholars, they will say to you that they've just conditioned that the sanad is sahih. That's all they conditioned. And that's not the case. Even though what Ibn al-Jazari here is saying, which is that the qira'at, the condition for it is al-shuhra, al-istifada, and that the ummah unanimously agree upon it, it's still weak view. We're going to debunk that bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, but we want to fairly represent the imam. And we want you all to understand what he's trying to say here. The second point I want to bring to your attentions is, and بعض المتأخرين, some of the late scholars, this is not the view of the متقدمين, by the way. This is not the view held by the early scholars of Al-Islam. This is views that came later. these mutaakhirin, الذين شذوا وخالفوا الإجماع, who went against the إجماع, who opposed the إجماع, what they are distinguishing between is the Qur'an and the qira'at. And this is very important. They are not saying that the Qur'an is not mutawatir. What they are saying is that the tawatur is not present in the qira'at. And this is something important for everybody to understand. They are saying بِأَنَّ الْقُرْآنَ مُتَوَاتِرٌ, that the Qur'an is mutawatir. And that they also are saying that the Qur'an, for it to be considered a Qur'an, a condition for it is that it has to be mutawatir. As for the qira'at, they say, فَلَا يُشْتَرَطُ التَّوَاتُرُ لِثُبُوتِهَا. They say that the qira'at, is not a prerequisite for it to be mutawatir. That's very important. And one of the people who are pushing that opinion as well is none other than Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. He has a kitab called Ibrazul Ma'ani, min Hirz al-Amani fil Qira'at al-Sab'ah. Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi has an explanation on the kitab of al-Imam al-Shatibi, Abu al-Qasim al-Shatibi. He explained his kitab, Hirz al-Amani wa Wajh al-Tani fil Qira'at al-Sab'ah. Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, in the beginning, the muqaddima, the first page of the kitab, Ibrazul al-Ma'ani, when he defines the Qur'an there, he says, Al-Qur'an kalamullah, that the Qur'an is the speech of Allah. Manqul, the Qur'an is transmitted to us. Naqlu tawatur, it's transmitted to us, a transmission of tawatur, he says. Ar-Rasulillahi, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alladhi unzila ilayhi, it was sent on him alayhi sallatu wa sallam. Lam yazal, he says, fi kulli hinin, that every time there was what? Jilun yanqulu khalqun la yuhsa, that there is a generation who were passing over the Qur'an, and the number of those people cannot be, it can't be counted. They are not a figure we can give. And the people who were transmitting the Qur'an were large in number, that he's saying. Yani Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi here is saying that the Qur'an is mutawatir, clearly and categorically. بينما نجده يقول عن القراءات في كتابه المرشد الوجيز إلى علوم تتعلق بالكتاب العزيز. Whereas when we look at his other kitab, المرشد الوجيز. When we go to his kitab, المرشد الوجيز, إلى علوم تتعلق بالكتاب العزيز, we find that he says something different about the قراءات. The Quran, he said, التواتر, المتواتر. But when it came to the قراءات in his kitab, Al-Murshid Al-Wajiz, we see him saying something different. What is it that he is saying? He says, فَالْحَاصِلُ أَنَّا لَسْنَا مِمَّنْ يَلْتَزِمُ التَّوَاتُرَ. He said, we are not from those who condition tawatur. And then he goes on to saying, after a bit, he says, بَلِ الْقِرَاءَاتُ كُلُّهَا مُنْقَسِمَ إِلَى مُتَوَاتِرُ وَغَيْرُ مُتَوَاتِرُ. That the qira'at, not the Qur'an, the qira'at is divided into mutawatir and that which is not mutawatir. وَغَايَةُ مَا يُبْدِيهِ مُدَّعِي تَوَاتُرِ الْمَشْهُورِ مِنْهَا كَإِدْغَامِ أَبِي عَمْرٍ وَنَقْلِ الْحَرَكَةِ لِوَرْشٍ وَوَصْلِ مِيمِ الْجَمْعِ وَهَاءِ الْكِنَايَةِ لِابْنِ كَثِيرٍ أَنَّهُ مُتَوَاتِرٌ عَنْ ذَلِكَ الْإِمَامِ الَّذِي نُسِبَ تِلْكَ الْقِرَاءَةِ إِلَيْهِ بَعْدَ أَنْ يُجْهِدَ نَفْسَهُ فِي إِسْتِوَاءِ الطَّرَفَيْنِ وَالْوَاسِطَةِ إلا أنه بقي عليه التواتر من ذلك الإمام إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في كل فرد من ذلك. He says the qira'at is categorized into two, qira'at which are mutawatira and qira'at which are not mutawatira. And then he goes on to saying وغاية ما يبديه, the most that is brought forward by those who claim tawatur is the idgham of Abi Amr and نقل الحركة لورش, and the نقل of the حركة of ورش. And I want you to hold on to the نقل الحركة لورش, because I'm going to give an example on that. And I'm going to give an example. He mentions so many, but I just chose نقل الحركة لورش. ووصل ميم الجمع وهاء الكناية لابن كثير أنه متواتر. This is all they bring forward to claim متواتر القراءات, he says. عن ذلك الإمام الذي نسبت إليه عن ذلك الإمام الذي نسب تلك القراءة إليه. That the rest, that qira'ah was attributed to that particular imam, he says. And then he says, that the after these people struggle who claim tawatur and they exert all their efforts, they are only able to reach tawatur with the qari himself. The qari himself, يعني if it's Abi Amr or whether it be Ibn Kathir or other than them, as when they reach him, the tawatur stops from them. Between him and the Prophet, there's no mutawatir anymore. فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ ثَمَّ لَمْ تُنْقَلْ إِلَّا أَحَادًا. From that minute onwards, he said, it's only been transmitted as ahad. إِلَّا الْيَسِيرَ مِنْهَا, except little things here or there. فَلَيْسَ الْأَقْرَبَ فِي ضَبْضِ هَذَا الْفَصْلِ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ ذَكَرْنَاهُ مِرَارًا. مِنْ أَنَّ كُلَّ قِرَاءَةٍ اِشْتُهِرَتْ بَعْدَ صِحَّةِ إِسْنَادِهَا وَمُوَافَقَتِهَا خَطَّ الْمُصْحَفِ وَلَمْ تُنْكَرْ مِنْ جِهَةِ الْعَرَبِيَّةِ فَهِيَ الْقِرَاءَةُ الْمُعْتَمِدَةِ عَلَيْهَا وَمَا عَدَى ذَلِكَ فَهُوَ دَاخِلٌ فِي حِيَزِ الشَّاذِ وَالضَّعِيفِ. The Imam then goes on to saying that the qira'ah, if it's famous, if it's spread, if it's prevalent, and the chain of narration is authentic, and it is in line with the Mus'haf of Uthman radiallahu anhu, and it does, the Arabic language is not rejected, then this is a qira'ah we rely on. This is a qira'ah which we rely on. And anything other than that, then of course it's shad and it's da'if. So in other words, what he's saying is that if the qira'ah is famous and it's common and it's prevalent, the chain of narration is authentic, it's in line with the Mus'haf, it's in line with the Arabic language, it is a qira'ah, then we accept. So it's not, he's not just saying that it has to be, chain has to be authentic. He's saying that sanad has to be sahih and it also has to be famous. Here I want you to understand the point that Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, number one, he distinguishes between the Qur'an being mutawatir and the qira'at being mutawatir. He acknowledges that the Qur'an is mutawatir. But here what he's saying is that the qira'at is what's divided into two. Qira'at which are mutawatir and qira'at which are not mutawatir. And then he gives examples of why he doesn't believe the qira'at to be mutawatira. And now I'm going to explain to you where the issue for Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi came from. One of the examples that he gave was وَنَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ لِوَرْشٍ. What does that mean? And what does that have to do with the discussion of whether the qira'at is mutawatir or not? You will now understand. So Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, he gives an example of what is known as نَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ. And this will make it clear for us. So I'm going to give two examples of the Qur'an regarding نَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Qur'an, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. We have the word وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Let's look at the word وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. We're going to learn today نَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ that Abu Shama gave as an example. It will make all clear to you what he means, that the qira'at, some of it is mutawatir and some of it is not mutawatir, and that the Qur'an is mutawatir but not the qira'at necessarily. What he means by that. Then we are able to respond to him or respond to his statement and his argument. And of course, it's not going to be us who's going to respond. We're going to respond by other scholars, what they said, inshallah ta'ala. So he says Naqlul al-Haraka was one of the examples he gave. According to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفَ is mutawatir. This recitation here as وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفَ is mutawatir. Good. Let's examine the ayah now. Allah says, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَان. So we have الْإِنسَان. الْإِنسَان, we have أَلِف and we have لَام. الْإِنسَان. أَلِف and لَام. What is the عَلَامَة on the لَام? Everyone, inshallah ta'ala, is going to say, the alama on the alif, sorry, the alama on the lam is a sukun. The alama on the lam is a what? Is a sukun. So sukun. So the lam is sakina. The lam has sukun on it. Good. What is it that has come after the lamb. After the lamb, what came after the lamb is a hamza. What came after it is a hamza. Good. So we have al insan. Insan. So there's a hamza there. So it's alif, lam. The lam has a sukoon on it. And after the lam is a hamza. This hamza, what does it have under it? What does that hamza got under it? That hamza has got a kasra under it. Then in the Arabic language, the dhamma, fatha, and kasra are called haraka. The sukoon is not haraka. Okay? So it's the hamza is mutaharrika. That has got a haraka on it. Good. The haraka here is a what? It's a kasra. So what does the qira of warsh do in this situation? The qira of warsh, what it does is that it moves. It moves that hamza from the place. That it eliminates it in totality. And then what does it do? It gives the haraka, the kasra, to the lamb. The lamb had a sukoon on it, right? The hamza disappears. Just before it's about to disappear, it passes over the kasra to the lamb. And it says, lamb, used to be sukoon. Now you can have a kasra. I'm leaving. And so the ayah becomes recited according to warsh. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. It's not وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ. It becomes وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. So the kasra of the lamb and the noon come together. Why is the lamb take a kasra? لِلْتِقَى إِسَاكِلَيْنِ. Two sukoons are going to meet one another. So to prevent it, the hamza, before it leaves, it gives it kasra. This is known as نَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ. It's called نَقْلُ الْحَرَكَةِ. So, according to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, the qira'ah which recites as وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, according to him, that is a qira'ah which is mutawatira. The qira'ah which recites as what? The qira'ah which recites as وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, according to him, is not mutawatir. Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. Why is it not mutawatir to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi? Because to him, it has not come in the number of tawatur. According to him, Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. This is vital information here. I'm going to go into the second example of Naqlu al-Haraka to make it clear for you again. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says, بَطَائِنُهَا مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقَ. Allah says that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. According to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, this qira'ah is mutawatir. This qira'ah is mutawatir. We have here, بَطَائِنُهَا مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقَ. We have a noon here. This noon, at the ending of it, what is on there, brothers? What is the last alama on the noon? You will say, it's noon sakina. The noon has a sukoon on it. Okay, after this noon, what is present? There's a hamza again. This hamza, what does it have? As a kasra, just like وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, the lamb had a sukoon on it and the hamza had kasra on it. This one is the same. مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقْ, the noon has a sukoon on it, and إِسْتَبْرَقْ, the hamza has a what? A kasra on it. According to warsh, it's going to be read as what? مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقْ. What do? We drop the hamza and the noon takes a kasra. Why? Because iltiqa is sakinain. We're scared that two sukoons are going to meet one another. Are we all together, brothers? This is what is known as naqlul haraka. According to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, min istabraq is not a qira'a which is mutawatira. According to him, he believes that min istabraq is not mutawatir. But he's saying that min istabraq is a mutawatir qira'a. Okay. Now, scholars have refuted and debunked this statement of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. Great scholars have. They've responded to him, they critiqued him on this issue, and they said that what he's saying is very flawed. And the great scholars that responded to him are 11 scholars. They are 11 scholars. I'm only going to transmit the statement of four of them, inshallah ta'ala. I'm just going to quote four, but I'm going to tell you the name of the rest, inshallah ta'ala. Now we have one great scholar, Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, on one side, who's a great scholar in this field. We admire his works. We appreciate him. Him saying something, and we have other great scholars saying something else. You have to judge between them. We don't just blind follow one person. We have to judge between them. We have to be, if we have the understanding, of course, and we are able to do that, then we look at who is mentioning what is right. We've now looked at the statement of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. We really understood it. We now have to look at the other scholars and what they said about his statement. And then inshallah ta'ala see who is right and who is wrong. The first scholar I'm going to mention who debunked the claim of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi is none other than Ibn al-Jazari rahimahullah. Ibn al-Jazari, who died in 833 Hijriya, he has a kitab called Munjid al-Muqri'in. He said, "Awqaftu alayhi shaykhana," I brought this statement to our shaykh. Who is he referring to? He's referring to Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Khatib. He said, I met him, and this is a great Shafi'i scholar. He said, I met him and I said to him, look at the statement of Abu Shama, the statement I read on you before. Then his great Shaykh, Ibn al-Jazari's teacher, Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Khatib, he said, Ma'adhur Abu Shama. Abu Shama is excused. Hasiba, he thought, anna al-qira'at kal-hadith. Hasiba, he thought, anna al-qira'at, that the qira'at is like the hadith. Makhrajuha ka makhrajih. He thought that the way that we look at the makhraj, the way we look at where the hadith comes from, is the same way that we look at the way the qira'at comes from. إِذَا كَانَ مَدَارُهَا عَلَى وَحِدٍ. Scholars of hadith, they go to a hadith, for example, if it comes to just one companion, they say it's ahad. بِغَضِّ النَّظَرِ. If in reality other people have narrated it, they don't care. They will just say it's ahad. I'll give an example. The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. This hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, who narrated it from the Prophet ﷺ? Umar radiallahu anhu. There is no other companion who has transmitted to us the hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Okay? Who heard it from Umar radiallahu anhu? Who narrated it from Umar radiallahu anhu? Alqamah ibn Abi Waqas al-Laythi. Now, what's strange is that Umar radiallahu anhu narrated the hadith innama al-amalu binniyat on the pulpit on a Friday khutbatul Jum'ah. And the only person that we have today who narrated the hadith of innama al-amalu binniyat is who? Alqamah ibn Abi Waqas al-Laythi. Ibn Hajar mentions Alqamah is disputed whether he's a companion or not. It's actually disputed. Okay? It's disputed whether he's a companion. If he's a companion, then Umar is a companion. Alqamah is a companion. Then the other two are not companions. They are tabi'in. So it would be two sahabas and two tabi'in. And Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari are both tabi'in. And Alqamah, if it's the view that he's a companion, and Umar, of course, is a companion, then it would be two companions in the chain and two tabi'in. But anyways, Alqamah ibn Abi Waqas al-Laythi, the strongest opinion that he's not a companion, is that he narrated this from Umar. But Umar said, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, on the pulpit. And we know how many people who can, Friday, khutbatul Jum'ah, how many people are going to hear it? I mean, Friday, khutbatul Jum'ah, in the city of Medina, the Amir al-Mu'mineen is doing a khutbatul Jum'ah. I mean, this is something a lot of people heard. Lakin, according to the scholars of hadith, because only one person who narrated it, scholars of hadith, they consider it ahad. Whether other people have heard it or not, it doesn't matter. Are we all together? So Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi fell into this problem. This problem became his mushkila. How? He looked at the qira'at because it goes back to one of the qurra, one of the imams. For example, it goes to Asim, or it goes to Ibn Kathir, or Abi Amr, or Nafi', or Qisa'i. That's it. It's ahad. Okay? No. These particular scholars were chosen because of their knowledge, and they came forward to narrate the Qur'an. But the people of the city, all of them knew the Qur'an, and all of them had that same recitation of Asim and Qisa'i. But one person was chosen to be documented. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to prove that more inshallah ta'ala. So Ibn Jazari here is bringing the statement of Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Khatib. He's saying that he said that Abu Shama's mushkila here is that he's looking at it like a hadith. وَخَفِيَ عَلَيْهِ what is hidden from him. أَنَّهَا إِنَّمَا نُسِبَتْ إِلَى ذَلِكَ الْإِمَامِ. This qira'ah was attributed to this imam. إِصْطِلَاحًا. It's a technical issue. It's not just that he's the only one who narrated the Qur'an. وَإِلَّا فَكُلُّ أَهْلِ بَلْدَةً. Rather, the people of that whole city and that whole village, like Kufa, for example, they all were narrating this with him. Okay? And then he goes on to say, لَمْ يُوَافِقْهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَحَدٌ بَلْ كَانُوا يَجْتَنِبُونَهَا وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِاجْتِنَابِهَا. And if the people of that village and that town and that city were not to agree with that imam in that recitation, they would have said, don't read it like that. They will prohibit the people from it. They warn against the people from it. And this statement of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, great scholars have also warned the people from it and told the people to stay away from it. So here is very clear, crystal clear, brothers, that the problem with Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi is that just because a recitation is attributed to one of the qurra, does not mean that he is the only one who read it. Okay, that's the difference here. This is tawatur al-tabaqa. Many people have narrated this Qur'an at the time of Asim. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to bring some examples. For example, Ibn Amir. Ibn Amir took the Qur'an from Abu Darda, the imam of the people of Sham. وَأَمَّا دِمَشْقُ الشَّامِ دَارُ ابْنُ عَامِرٍ فَتِلْكَ بِعَبْدِ اللَّهِ طَابَتْ مُحَلَّلًا. Ibn Amir is the imam of the people of Sham, right? Ibn Amir's teacher is Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu. How many people did Ibn Amir narrate from? How many people took the Qur'an with him? 1,600 people took with him. I'm going to bring it inshallah ta'ala. But we don't have those 1,600 people. We only have Ibn Amir only here, written for us. But we know through authentic chains of narrations that Ibn Amir was a student of Abu Darda, who Abu Darda was teaching this much of the people. But the only person we want to quote is because Ibn Amir. Why? Because Ibn Amir came forward to teach the Qur'an, became known for it, and that's why it got attributed to him. Like Ibrahim al-Naqa'i used to even hate the idea of saying qira'atu fulan, sanadu fulan, the qira'at of so-and-so, the chain of so-and-so. He used to dislike that because he was scared that what Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi fell into, that a lot of people are going to fall into. Now I'm going to mention the second imam who also debunked the issue of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. And that is Burhanuddin Ibrahim ibn Umar al-Ja'bari. Al-Ja'bari has a kitab called خُلَاصَةُ الْأَبْحَاثِ فِي شَرْحِ الْقِرَاءَةِ الثَّلَاثِ. He said, لَقَدْ كَانَ نَقَلَتْ وُجُوهِ الْقِرَاءَةِ خَلْقًا يَعْصُرُ حَصْرُهُمْ كَشَيْبَةِ بْنُ النَّصَّاحِ وَبْنُ جُنْدُبْ وَبْنُ هُرْمُزْ وَبْنُ مُحَيْصٍ هُوَ الْأَعْمَشِ وَعَاصِمْ الْجَحْدَرِي and people like them. فَلَمَّا طَالَتِ الْمُدَّةِ وَقَصُرَتِ الْهِمَمِ اقْتُصِرَ عَلَى بَعْضِهِمْ وَكَانُوا هَؤُلَاءِ إِمَّا لِتَصْدِيهِمْ لِلِاشْتِغَالِ أو لأنهم شيوخ المقتصر ولو عين غيرهم لجاز أو غيرهم هؤلاء عنهم جاز وخفي هذا الأمر على أكثر المقرئين. He says something very powerful, Al-Ja'bari. He says that لقد كان نقلت وجوه القراءات. Those who've transmitted the recitation of the قراءات are خلقا, are a number of people. يعصر حصرهم. We cannot count them. They're too much. For example, some of the people, scholars, إشيبة بن النصاح, Ibn Jundub, Ibn Hurmuz, Ibn Muhaysin, Al-A'mash, Asim Al-Jahdari, and people like them. But when the time became long and the people's aspiration became short, people get tired of knowing everyone. People just want to know, okay, just tell me one or two people so I can remember. So scholars just restricted it to a group of people. And the reason why these one were chosen over these one is because they came forward to teach. Asim came forward to teach. Are we all together? Ibn Amr and Ibn Amr al-Ala'i al-Basri and Kisa'i and Nafi' and Ibn Kathir, they came forward to teach. But that doesn't mean that they were the only ones who knew the Qur'an, who memorized the Qur'an. يعني the people who were studying the Qur'an with them is عَدَدُ يَعْصُرُ حَصْرُهُمْ. They cannot be counted. So that statement of al-Ja'bari is very, very strong. The third statement I want to mention is the statement of Salahuddin Khalil al-Kaykaldi al-Ala'i al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. He has a kitab called Al-Majmu' al-Mudhab fi Qawa'id al-Madhab. He's a great Shafi'i scholar. He has written a book on Qawa'id al-Fiqh and Usul al-Fiqh, one of the greatest books. And the great Imam al-Ala'i rahimahullah, he combined between the knowledge of hadith and also the knowledge of fiqh and usul al-fiqh and qawa'id al-fiqhiyah. So his book, when you read it, you'll be amazed with it. So if you buy the best publication out there so far, is the Awqaf al-Kuwait. They published it. That's the best publication. The previous publications, they had so much mistakes in there. Some of the pages are repetitions. Some pages are blank. Like in the Awqaf al-Kuwait, taba'ah, very good. Al-Ala'i says, rahimahullah, when he was debunking Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, he says, يُوهِمُ أَنَّ الْقِرَاءَةَ السَّبْعَ لَيْسَتْ مُتَوَاتِرَةً كُلِّهَا. He transmitted the statement of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, al-Ala'i, and then he says, يُوهِمُ الْقِرَاءَةَ. He says, it falsely gives the impression that أَنَّ الْقِرَاءَةَ السَّبْعَ لَيْسَتْ مُتَوَاتِرَةً كُلِّهَا. That all of the قِرَاءَةَ السَّبْعَ are not mutawatir. وَأَنَّ عَلَاهَا مَجْتَمَعَ فِي سِحَةُ السَّنَدِ وَمُوَافَقَةُ خَطِّ الْمُصْحَفِ فِي الْإِمَامِ وَالْفَصِيحِ مِنْ لُغَةِ الْعَرَبِ. And it gives the impression that the highest level of the qira'at is that the chain is authentic, it is in line with the Mus'haf of Uthman radiallahu anhu, and it's in line with the Arabic language. وَأَنَّهُ يَكْتَفِي فِيهَا الْإِسْتِفَاضَةَ. And enough is for it to be famous. وَلَيْسَ الْأَمْرُ كَمَا ذَكَرَ هَؤُلَاءِ. And the issue is not what they said, these people. And who's he referring to? Abu Shama. And those who hold that opinion. And he says, وَلَيْسَ الْأَمْرُ كَمَا ذَكَرَ هَؤُلَاءِ. And the matter is not what these people have claimed. وَالشُّبْهَةُ دَخَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ إِنْحِصَارِ أَسَانِيدِهَا وَالشُّبْهَةُ دَخَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ إِنْحِصَارِ أَسَانِيدِهَا فِي رِجَالٍ مَعْرُوفِينَ. And he said that this shubha entered into these people's hearts because the Qur'an is attributed to particular narrators. فَظَنُّوهَا كَالْأَخْبَارِ الْآحَادِ. So they thought it was ahad. وَهَذَا مَوْضِعٌ يَنْبَغِي التَّنْبِيهُ لَهُ. And this is a matter that many people have to be aware of. وَأَلَّا يَغْتَرَّ بِقَوْلِ الْقُرَّائِ. And do not be deceived by the statements of those reciters, يعني Abu Sham and others. وَاللَّهُ الْمُوَفَقُ. And Allah is the one who gives the ability. And Al-Ja'bari before, what did he say? وَخَفِي هَذَا الْأَمْرُ عَلَى أَكْثَرِ الْمُقْرِئِينَ. And this is the issue that many of the Qurra'i became hidden from them. They became what? Became hidden from them. And so Al-Ala'i here is saying what? وَأَلَّا يَغْتَرَّ بِقَوْلِ الْقُرَّىٰ. Do not be deceived by the statement of Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi and others like that. Don't be deceived by it. Now I'm going to give you the statement of two other great scholars, Ibn Amir al-Hajj and Zamlakani. By the way, the scholars who have transmitted this and debunked Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi in this issue are 11 scholars. I'm going to mention their names. And I'm going to then quote, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to then quote the Ibn Amir al-Hajj and also al-Zamlakani. And the rest, I'm just going to give you their names, inshallah ta'ala. So I might as well just tell you the names of the rest. So those great scholars I'm going to mention, inshallah ta'ala, are Ibn Amir al-Haji, Waliuddin Abu Zur'at al-Iraqi, Badruddin al-Zarkashi, al-Zamlakani, Zainuddin Zakariya al-Ansari, al-Allama Ahmad ibn Abd al-Rahman, Hululu, صاحب أضواء اللامع, where he explains the جمع الجوامع. He mentions it there. شهاب الدين أحمد البنا, عبد العلي نظام الدين الأنصاري, يعني, and also Ibn Jazari and Burhan الدين إبراهيم ابن عمر الجعبري and صلاح الدين خليل الكيكلدي العلائي. Those 11 are all of the scholars who refuted and debunked Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. I've already quoted three great imams already, quoted them word for word. Ibn al-Jazari, Ja'bari, and also al-Ala'i. I'm going to add Ibn Amir al-Hajji's statement and also Zamlakani, Kamaluddin Ibn Zamlakani. What they said, that will make it, inshallah ta'ala, five statements, inshallah ta'ala. Five quotes, bi'idhnillah al-Kareem. They'll make it five quotes, inshallah ta'ala. And the rest, bi'idhnillah al-Kareem, you can look for their statements yourself and see that this is the correct view, inshallah ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Jazari, rahimahullah, when the statement of Burhanuddin Ibrahim ibn Umar al-Ja'bari was mentioned, he quoted it in his kitab, Munjid al-Muqri'in. He brought the kalam of Burhanuddin Ibrahim ibn Umar al-Ja'bari that I mentioned before in his kitab, Khulasatu al-Abhath fi Sharh al-Qira'at al-Thalath. Ibn al-Jazari transmitted that statement, and then he said right after it, هَذَا كَلَامُ صَحِيحُ لَا مِرْيَةَ فِيهِ, that the statement of Burhanuddin Ibrahim ibn Umar al-Ja'bari is a statement which is correct and there is no debate regarding it. So this shows us that Ibn al-Jazari agrees with the statement of al-Ja'bari when he refuted Abu Shamit al-Maqdisi. Now I'm going to mention the statement of Kamaluddin ibn Zamlakani. Ibn Zamlakani, he said, انحصار الأسانيد في طائفة لا يمنع مجيء القراءات عن غيرهم فقد كان يتلقاه أهل كل بلد بقراءة إمامهم الجم الغفير عن مثلهم وكذلك دائما فالتواتر حاصل لهم ولكن الأئمة الذين قصدوا ضبط الحروف وحفظوا عن شيوخهم منها جاء السند من جهتهم وهذا كالأخبار الواردة في حجة الوداع هي أحد ولم تزل حجة الوداع منقولة عمن يحصل بهم التواتر عن مثلهم في كل عصر فهذه كذلك وهذا ينبغي التفطن له وألا يغتر بقول القراء فيه. Kamaluddin al-Zamlakani said exactly the statements that I mentioned from the previous great imams, the statement of Ibn al-Jazari and also al-Ja'bari and the statement of al-Ala'i al-Kaykaldi. He said that restricting the chains to a particular group does not prevent the Qur'an coming as mutawatir. Okay? Or it doesn't prevent that the Qur'an, the qira'at came from some other scholars as well. It's not preventing that. Because every single people, they would narrate it, the qira'ah of their imam. And the people who narrate it from him would be large in number. And the ones he studied with are large in number. And وهكذا, until the Prophet ﷺ. And then he gave an example of the Hajjatul Wada'. The Hajjatul Wada', he said it's ahad, it's singular in narration. But remember how many people were standing in front of the Prophet ﷺ that day. Thousands of people standing. But did everybody choose to narrate it? No. So it's mutawatir in the sense where many people narrated it. Many people heard it. But there's few who chose to narrate it. A few choose to narrate it. Or a few choose to come forward to bring it. Ibn Amir al-Hajji, and then he says, before I go into Ibn Amir al-Hajji's statement, he says, وَأَلَّا يُغْتَرَّ بِقَوْلِ الْقُرَّاءِ فِيهِ. Do not be deceived by the statements of the Qurra regarding this, referring to Abu Shamit al-Maqdisi and others. Ibn Amir al-Hajji, he said in his kitab, in the sharh of his kitab, where he explains the tahrir, written by Kamaluddin ibn Humam, who died in 861. Zamlakani died the year 727 Hijriah. Ibn Amir died 879 Hijriah. He said, جَمِيعُ الْقُرْآنِ مُتَوَاتِرٌ إِجْمَاعًا لِكَوْنِ الْعَادَةِ قَاضِيَةً بِهِ قَالُوا أي القائلون بالاشتهار المنسوب إليهم هذه القراءات آحاد لأنهم سبعة نفر والتواتر لا يحصل بهذا العدد فيما اتفقوا عليه فضلا عما اختلفوا فيه أجيب بأن نسبتها إلى القراءات السبع إليهم لاختصاصهم بالتصدي للاشتغال والإشغال بها والاشتهار بذلك لا لأنهم النقلة خاصة بمعنى أن رواتهم مقصورة عليهم بل عدد التواتر موجود معهم في كل طبقة إلى أن ينتهي إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Ibn Amir al-Haji, he says that all of the qira'at are mutawatira by consensus. And these people could not have agreed upon this. And then he said that these people who argue that No, it's not possible that the qira'at are mutawatirah. All that matters is that it's famous and it's prevalent. وَمَا إِلَى ذَلِكَ يعني the statement of Abu Shama. They argued, they said the qura'at are how many? Only seven? Seven is not mutawatir. If they all agreed upon it, it's still not mutawatir, let alone when they differ amongst themselves. He refuted that Ibn Amir al-Hajj. And he said that the attribution to these people in the first place, these seven, doesn't mean that they're only seven. They're uluf mu'allafa. Thousands of people narrated it. Okay? But these seven were chosen لِخْتِصَاصِ بِالتَّصَدِّي. They were unique in coming forward to teach. They came forward to educate the people. And they became famous for that. But it doesn't mean that they're the only people. And they're the only ones. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to explain this more in the upcoming episodes. So inshallah ta'ala, keep that in mind. So summary. We said that Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi's statement has been debunked by great scholars. 11 scholars. Of course, this episode is probably the longest episode from all of the episodes. If I went and quoted the other imams, it would have gone longer and longer. This view goes against the ijma' that we mentioned before. And the ijma' is something that we need to follow. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Those mutaakhirin, I've read Rasail Jami'iyya written, and some people saying that this issue, ijma' is not right. It's just qawlul jumhur. The issue, don't accept that. It is an ijma'. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.